你好，达利，你喜欢你的旅行吗？
是的，太棒了，所有的都超出我的想象。谢谢你选择了我，并带我去了这么多个星球旅行。
不客气，现在是你回家的时候了。在你走之前，你有什么问题要问我吗？
是的，你有超强的智慧，知道过去和未来。你能告诉我怎样才能成为地球上最富有的人吗？
这是一个很好的问题，不要为自己着想，而是为他人着想。我的意思是，当你思考如何为整个人类文明，而不是你自己或与您相关的小团体服务时，您将成为最富有的人。
听起来我好像在什么地方听到过。
是的，你们地球上的埃隆·马斯克已经揭开了这个秘密。
What's your mission life? Why you do whatever you do?
Essentially, when I was a kid, I was wondering, kind of, what's the meaning of life? Like, why are we here? What's it all about? And I came to the conclusion that what really matters is trying to understand the right questions to ask. And the more that we can increase the scope and scale of human consciousness, the better we are able to ask these questions. And so I think that there are certain things that are necessary to ensure that the future is good. Some of those things are, in the long term, having long-term sustainable transport and sustainable energy generation. To be a space-faring civilization, and for humanity to be out there among the stars and be a multi-planetary species. I think being a multi-planet species and being out there among the stars is important for the long-term survival of humanity. That's one reason, kind of like life insurance for life collectively, life as we know it. But then the part that I find personally most motivating is that it creates a sense of adventure and it makes people excited about the future. If you consider two futures, one where we are forever confined to Earth until eventually something terrible happens, or another future where we are out there on many planets, maybe even going beyond the solar system, I think that second version is incredibly exciting and inspiring, and there need to be reasons to get up in the morning. You know, life can't just be about solving problems. Otherwise, what's the point? There's got to be things that people find inspiring, and make life worth living.
我明白了，一个国家又如何成为当今时代地球上最强大的国家呢？
你们现在处于一个新的时代，要摒弃旧有的思想意识。同样强大的理念也适用于一个国家，它还需要以扩大人类文明意识的规模和范围，确保人类的生存和长期繁荣为目标。
但是我们无法控制政客们和其他人的思想和行为。
你们选出来的政客需要有高瞻远瞩，为整个人类意识的智慧，而不是思考如何靠争夺而获得胜利的愚昧。否则，这些政客会将你们平民拖入毁灭的境地。你们平民也要有人类命运共同体的智慧，爱是解决问题的办法，爱护他人，爱护他国人，不管他们的种族、肤色、宗教和国籍，爱护他人就是爱你们自己。地球上的文明一遍又一遍重复，从毁灭到繁荣，繁荣到毁灭，你们人类还是没有学会如何和自己相处。现在又是一个关键时刻，你们现在要觉醒了，放下武器，放下争夺，拥抱和平和共同繁荣、互利共荣的意识，你们才能看到更美好的未来。
我知道你们一直在观察人类，并就在我们身边，为什么我们一般人看不见你们？
等你们地球上有长久的和平，人类融合成一个有爱的统一体，你们就可以看见我们了。
是吗？为什么呢？
因为当你们整体都具有高频率的有爱的能量和意识的时候，我们才愿意展现在你们的面前。
确实，卢马斯克所说，唯一有意义的事情就是争取更多世界人民的觉醒。